Hello and welcome to this tutorial on how to change the clutch on the DRZ-400. So what you're going to need for this is a DRZ-400, a clutch kit. Today I'm going to be using the EBC heavy duty clutch, which comes with heavier clutch springs and shit. And you're going to need tools. So I'm going to use some sockets because you need to take this part off. So I'm going to be using sockets, and then inside of it there's a few Allen screws that you need to take out. So I'll swap to those in a bit. But first, what you need to do is, because I'm going to also be doing a service on my bike because it's been about 1200 Ks, I need to take this bash plate off and I need to drop the fluids out of it. So once I've done that, we'll get into it. Okay, so now that we've got the fluids out of the bike, the next thing that we want to do is go ahead and put the new clutch plates in some oil for a couple of hours, just so that way they can get a bit lubricated and be ready to put into the bike. One thing I want to bring up before I put them in is that bottom clutch plate's going to have a smaller circle, smaller friction part than the other ones. As you can see, this one's a bit more meatier, this one's a bit thinner. That's how you know that that's the first one that goes in, closest to the gearbox. So we just want to let those soak in there for a couple of hours. I'm going to go do something else until, what time is it now? 11:15, I guess I'll come back at maybe 1-ish, and then I'll do the rest of them. Okay, so now that we've got the clutch plate soaking for a few hours and we've got all the oil bolts back in, we can go ahead and mark the numbers on the bolts on this clutch plate here. If you don't know why we're doing that, it's because some bolts are longer than the others. And if you go to put a long bolt in a short bolt hole, it probably won't fit in the first place, but if it does, it's going to punch the case and you're going to have all kinds of issues and you have to replace this whole part here. So we're just going to go ahead and mark them all. To remove the clutch plate, we're going to need an 8mm. 8mm socket. With a bit of luck, I won't over-torque any of these bolts, and I won't break any. Okay, so now I've got all the bolts off of here. Okay, so now that we've got that off, just move the rear brake out of the way, and we can get to the clutch pack. But yeah, you just want to get an Allen key, oh, an Allen thingamajig hex fucking socket. Just undo these, it's pretty simple. It's not really rocket science for this part, it's fucking fairly easy to replace a clutch in a dirt bike. Fuck. Alright. Now that that's off, this little plate here should just come out. Okay. Looks good. This is the fun part. These holes here, so you can put your fingers in. Friction plate, steel plate, friction plate, steel plate. Maybe it's not so you can put your fingers in, because that's a tight fit. Okay, so now we start to do the new plates. So, I've got to fish through all these and find the thin one, which is right here, which was easy. As you can see, it's a lot thinner, so it goes first. It's pretty hard to fuck this up. Just goes in like that. Thin one's in, and then we go. A steel. She just goes on like that. And then it's pretty self-explanatory from there. Then a steely boy. So where it sits offset is only the last clutch plate. The rest of them just go in the normal way. So it just goes friction steel, friction steel, friction steel, this one. So that's on there, looks pretty good. Yeah, so now this bit goes back on. It's quite easy, goes on like that. Go ahead and open this. Hey, okay, it opens itself, that works. And we just go ahead and put the fucking screws in there. Yeah, they fit. It's good. Go ahead and get our wrench. Hopefully we haven't fucked this up, because that would really suck. Just get it threaded. Go ahead and get a new one. I tried making this an informative video, but things, when you're working in mechanics and stuff like that, never really go to plan. Like, for an example, today, when I dropped the oil out of my bike, I couldn't find any copper washers, so I had to ride a push bike, I don't know, 1.5 k's down to the store to get it, get 2 copper washers. This bike definitely needed a clutch. Clutch in this bike had been acting up for the last 3 months or so now, and I just waiting for that last thing, and recently it's been slipping a lot and just carrying on. So now that the clutch basket's back in, and the clutch plates are in, and hopefully everything went all to plan, then we can start putting these screws back in. I bet as soon as I start this bike up and go to put in gear, it stalls and I have eternal issues with this clutch. Hopefully that's not the case. Do these in until they get firm. I don't really think they need to be torqued to spec, so I'm just going diagonally through them and getting them on there with even pressure. Pretty sure that's the way you should do most things when you're working on an engine. It's just even pressure, make it all nice. Right, so I got that done. Got that seal back on. Oh, hopefully that worked. I guess we'll find out when oil pisses out of it, but hey. Okay, so you just want to go over these ones diagonally too. Probably not super tight, just tight enough. There we go. It doesn't look like it's going to go anywhere. So, yeah, we can put oil back in it, I guess.